Good evening from The Gambia. My name is Kiaria Tujalo. I'm the session host for this talk. The talk is going to be on Making Maps by Frederick Rodrigo. The talk will be in 20 minutes, then question and answers. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Frederick Rodrigo from Machina Corpus, and I will talk you about Machina Map. Machina Map is a new stack to render a vector tile based on OpenMap tile. For now, what we have? We have a raster tile used on OpenStreetMap.org based on OSM to PGSQL and MapNIC. It's based on Postgres and PostGIS for the database, OSM to PGSQL to load data and update into the database, and then MapNIC to render data from SQL to raster tiles and RenderD and mob tile to serve this tile to the web. On the other side, we have the OpenMapTile project for vector tiles. OpenMapTiles is a project to build vector tiles. It's also based on Postgres and PostGIS, but the schema of the data are different. For OpenMapTiles, the data are imported by InfoSM, and then are exported to Mapbox Vector Tiles, MVT, and stored in MBTiles. What the difference? The difference is here we don't static tiles. There is not request the raster tiles on request. So it's take time to generate all the data for an extract or even for the planet. If you want to import OpenMap tiles data for the planet and export it, it will take 4 weeks in a standard computer if you don't choose a cluster. And it will generate 55 gigabyte MB tiles. So when you have MB tiles, you also need something to serve vector tiles on the web. You can use for this TileServerGL, reading for MB tiles and serving tiles. TileServerGL also able to serve style to render the vector tiles on the browser or on the client side. Raster tiles are rendered from zoom 0 to 20 or even more, while vector tiles are only built from 0 to 14. Why? Because with vector tiles, you can rescale tiles and extend the tiles built for zoom 14 to other zoom. We call it over zoom. What we want? For sure, we want the best of the two worlds. We want vector tiles, but we also want to render the tile on request with up-to-date data. And we don't want to generate MB tiles for an exploit like continent or the planet. That take a while, and it's big, and it take again a while when you want to update it. So, we want to render vector tiles on request, and we want to be able to update the database from the diff and compute on request tile from the updated database. For this, there is an OpenMapTile project. OpenMapTile project already produced tiles, as we just see. It's based on Progress and PostGIS database loaded by InfoSM. After the InfoSM import, the OpenMap tiles have a set of SQL script to prepare the data and generalize the data. Like, for example, to merge Igwe, to have a better better localization of label when the data are displayed. And then OpenMapTile export to MBTile using a PostServe. PostServe read from the database and expose Mapbox Vector Tiles MVT on HTTP. And is used to build Mapbox Vector Tiles. So we use OpenMapTile as a base for our project Machina Map. Machina Map use the same bases from OpenMapTile, but does not read from PostServe and store to MBTiles. The idea is to have tiles on request. So we use an Nginx web server to read from PostServe. We also use a tile server, but not to serve from MBTiles, but to serve stack, for example. All the stack is set up in Docker to help deployment and make it easy to test the project. And you can set up a tile server with rendering on request in minutes, but for sure not the data in minutes. It depends on the extract you want to log. From minutes to hour or even day for the planet. But it's not so easy that just plug Nginx on top of OpenMapTiles. It does not work. Why? Because there is limitation on OpenMapTiles. The first limitation is the building data layer. The duration to generate tiles from OpenMapTiles are not bounded to the same limitation of the Mapnik stack. On the Mapnik stack, low zoom tiles take longer than others. On OpenMapTiles, as you can see on the graph, in a dense urban area where there is a lot of feature, tiles can take 1 second to be generated. Because there is a lot of data, and because we already generated data in the database directly, while Mapnik approach make requests directly on the imported data, and low-zoom tiles get longer to be generated, but they are cached. Here we have to improve the duration to generate zoom 14 level tiles. The limitation is due to building. In dense areas, there is a lot of building. Vector tiles are twice bigger than raster tiles, so there is even more building in a tiles. In a tiles like in Paris area, there is a 214,000 building in one tiles. It's an average and not most tiles we can have in this area. So we have to improve this. To improve this, we have to reduce the number of tables used by OpenMapTiles. OpenMapTiles at the start of our project was using many tables to store the building. By reducing the number of tables, we have already made improvement in speed for generating tiles, but the best thing we can achieve is by reducing the number of rows in the table to reduce the usage of indexes and read from the database. To do this, we cluster, but a very simple way, just by grouping buildings using a grid. We group buildings and save buildings as the PostGIS collection, as it's grouped, is not the merge of building. So when we make tiles, we can ungroup the buildings with the same attributes, and we can serve tiles as was before. The second limitation is the usage of materialized view in OpenMapTiles. Generalized data are done in materialized view. Materialized view allow to store the request used to generate generalized data, but in a materialized way. So the request and the result of the request is stored. This speed up the query when we generate tails, but when we want to update this materialized view, we have to recompute fully the materialized view. And so just applying a small diff need a lot of computation to update materialized view, and is not interesting to do this. Another drawback, a materialized view have to have some kind of primary key to be updated, and not all materialized view in OpenMapTiles have this kind of key. So when there is not this key, the update of the materialized view need to lock the view. And when it's locked, you cannot even read from the materialized view. And if you cannot read, you cannot serve tags. So we cannot use materialized view, and we have to drop materialized view and replace with something else. What we use in place, we use simply tables. We use the same query as the materialized view and save the result in a table. And when we want to update it, we use a trigger from the original table to make a differential update of the generalized table. It really speed up the update, and we can more quickly apply diff. But in the other side, we have to write code to update the generalized data. All these things are still a work in progress. We are making this work in a clone of the OpenMapTiles project for the Machina map. And when it's ready and tested, we forward the improvement to the OpenMapTiles project. So the building cluster grid is not yet integrated, and the differential update is already integrated, but it's still in progress. All materialized views have not been dropped yet. So once we have data and we can quickly get data and quickly update data, we have to serve tiles. Serve tiles, we will use the PostServe mini server from OpenMapTiles project. Even if in the doc the PostServe is not set as production ready, but we are still using it for now. Previously, the vector tiles were generated using Mapnik and TileLive, but since PostGIS is now able to directly generate Mapbox vector tiles, is really more interesting since the SQL query directly returns binary data, and this binary data is just the Mapbox vector tiles. The PostServe is also allow to serve metadata information named TileJSON. Metadata containing in particular the attribution of the data. So we have no tiles and metadata information, and we need to bring this to the web. Used for this Nginx. Nginx fetch tiles from PostServe, but also cache the tiles. And besides this, we have a tile server GL. Tile server GL can also fetch vector tiles from PostServe and rasterize these vector tiles to PNG and serve vector tiles for leaflet, for example, not supporting vector tiles. Along this, tile server is still able to serve MB tiles, for example, for Shadow. And Tile Server is serving a static file for Mapbox GL style. Okay. The update, there is still some point to see. MPOSM pull OSM diff from a web service like GeoFabric and apply this diff to the database. He updates the original table, firing the trigger, updating the derived other table, and MPOSM also produces a list of tiles to be updated from this data. This list is sent to Nginx to invalidate the cache of tiles. The strategy is simple here, just deleting the old tiles. Is not so advanced as RenderD, allowing many strategies to invalidate cache. We have an overview here. In the bottom, OpenStreetMap data and update loaded by InPoSM in the OpenMapTiles database. The OpenMapTiles database is requested by PostServe on request for serving Mapbox vector tiles to the web through Nginx. Also can be served tiles to Tile Server GL to rasterize vector tiles. And Tile Server can also serve still and Mapbox still JSON and other tiles from MB tiles like contour line, shadow. So while we are working on this project, we also have some other aside need to have extra layer to OpenMapTiles. OpenMapTiles is a generic set of data layer, and sometimes we need other things. One thing that become often for need is, for example, be able to interact with the vector tile, because we can interact on vector tile, you can click on feature, you can inline feature, and we need administrative polygon to be able to select an area or to click on area and get feature information about this area. So administrative polygon and not just only a limit as usually. Another test project was bicycle attribute to add some few layers to store bicycle route and bicycle details. So we can have add-on to the OpenMapTiles to also serve this feature. And with this data layer, we also draw Mapbox GL styles to display it. And here on the right, you can also see a tree is another test feature layer. To conclude, we can provide with Machina Map stack, standard Mapbox vector tiles usable for other projects as standard tiles, like Maplib or new Maplib project, Mapbox GL for sure, QGIS, OpenLayer, and so on. We use an improved and optimized version of OpenMapTiles. It's still not able to use minute diff on the planet because there is still need optimization and materialized view dropping is not done. But I think we'll be able to do this soon. The stack is done with Docker, allowing easy test and deployment. And as we see, the difficulties is not on the same place as the MapNIC stack, because of pre-computation and hard computation is not always in the same place as on OpenMap tiles is pre-generation and storage in the database, while in MapNIC stack, the long computation takes place directly on generating tiles. So a quick demo just before I left you. On the home page of the Machina Map server, you have on the left a list of style variables and on the bottom a list of data available. Ici only one data and many styles using the same vector tile set. Here's the vector map, and you can switch style, still using the same data set. For example, the Cassini styles using a demo style or looking for old map, and the bicycle still using the extra layer embedded in the same tile set. Thank you for listening, and I hope I will meet you soon.
Thank you. So the questions I have is one, would the Machina stack be suitable for saving vector tiles in other schemes than OpenMap tiles?
OpenMap tiles serve tiles in real time from the database, and the database can be updated in continuous, not exactly using minidiff yet because the optimization is not fully done.
Okay, that's the only question we have here, unless you want to add anything, but I will tell if anybody have questions or feedback, they can reach you at the postdoc chat room.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.